Daniel Stecich of Athena Advisor Services has his eyes on chart patterns for us today. Thanks so much for coming on this Monday, Daniel.
Happy to be here.
I want to start with Walgreens because this is a stock that had a very interesting week last week. It sold off heavily and then had a bounce back. Would you be a buyer here?
Yeah, I would be a buyer. You know, people ask me all the time, what do you buy in these markets? And they've been really heavily on the strong side. So I always say you have to look for a stock that's fallen down for some reason, then start analyzing the fundamentals. And Walgreens was at near a 52-week high. It was about 72 before they finally decided they weren't going to go through with this inversion. They nailed the stock about 20% and went all the way down to 58 before it started coming up a little bit. The P.E. on this stock's about 20. It has a 2% dividend, and it's a solid stock. If you look at this thing historically, it does well all the time. I think this is a stock, even with the bounce we had last week, that still has some more room to run to the upside.
Daniel, from your trader's perspective, if Walgreens would have gone through with this tax inversion plan, do you think it would have been damaging to the stock?
You know, it's an interesting question. I kind of doubt it because a few companies have done it, and it has done real well. Eaton's a classic example. They did their inversion, and the stock skyrocketed after the fact. Now, they lost a little bit last earnings period, but that's beside the point. There was a lot of social and sentiment against Walgreens doing this, but ultimately, people have a favorite store. If they do a good job, which they do, it would have helped them. They would have made more money. I don't think they would have lost a lot of sales.
Do you think that Tesla will be a stock worth watching? This is a stock that really ignited last week, had a nice run.
Yeah, you know, it's always a stock worth watching, but I look at the stock, it's sitting up at $248. It's got an estimated P.E. of 221. I think this thing's ridiculously valued right now. It's not that big a growth company. This company will sell 35,000 cars this year. For a frame of reference, Ford sold 221,000 cars in the month of July. They got a P.E. of 20. Tesla's going to be a good company, but is it going to be a company worth $248 a share? Unless they have some magic in that battery that they're talking about, the new technology, I don't think so. I think this one's probably going lower. Not significantly so, but cautiously short this one.
Daniel, great to get your thoughts today. Thank you.
Thank you. Had a good time.